Hello, today I'm going to show you the three different options we have when it comes to performing verification on documents within ABBYY FlexiCapture. The first way I'll show you is manual verification. The next one is group verification, and the last will be field verification. Now for manual verification, we simply open a document within a queue, which you can see here on the screen, and you can go one by one by reviewing the documents. Now, the benefit of this is that you get a good overall sense of what was extracted. You get to see the whole document. You get to see every single field that was extracted. The consequence of this is that sometimes the process can be a little bit slower because, as you can see, anything in red, the software is highlighting as a lack of confidence. In other words, it questions how well it read that given character, and the fact that it had a question about it, it's going to highlight that in red for me. So I would go one by one through those errors, and as I click, the software will take me to that spot and I will resolve the error. So that's our first one. We call this manual verification, and you can see that here. Also, if we do have an error on the document, like a business rule error, then those errors are located at the bottom. So sometimes that actually is helpful to do verification this way, especially if we have a number of different rules that are violated, and also if we have a limited document set as well. The next way I'll show you is group verification, and to do that, we simply highlight the documents and we will go to verification and run data verification. When we do group verification, there's a couple of things you should know. First off, the software labels it as group verification, and the reason why I point that out is because you can actually do a mix between group verification and field verification. In fact, in this demo, you will see a mixture of group verification and manual verification or field verification here as well. So in group verification, the software says, hey, this is what we've recognized as a checked checkmark field. And so every single checkmark in all of these documents in the batch, it's pulled off for me, and it's telling us and giving us the option to see them all at once. If at any time I want to override a valid checkmark, say for example, maybe this one here is not a valid one, I can simply click on it and put it in question or fix it. And actually by clicking it, it may be a little bit difficult to see in the video, but it's actually saying that this is no longer checked. Or if I want to follow up with it later, I can actually click it again and there will put a red check mark. And that red check mark is simply just me saying that I don't know the answer right now and I will come back to that later. I can also right click and show the character image. So if I need to get a little bit more specific on what's checked there and to have a little bit more broader sense of what that specific document and what that specific check mark is, I can do that as well. Now, grouped verification can do much more than check marks. So for example, here's one that's very similar where the software is saying, okay, now I'm showing you the unchecked check marks, but it can also show me the different characters. So the software is saying it recognized these characters in the documents as zeros, and I can simply review them and see what's going on and see if I agree, and I would agree in this case. The software recognized this character as one and these characters at two. Now, as you and I can probably see, the software mischaracterized these two characters. In fact, I may even right-click and show them to you quickly that you and I can probably tell that the number is one. So if I want to correct them, all I need to do is type over it. So I'm going to fix them and say, nope, the software recognized them as two, but I'm going to correct them and put them as one. So I'm just literally typing over the character and correcting them to the number one. These look like threes, and these were characterized as fives, and so on and so on. In fact, here's a good example where the software is recognizing these characters as six, but you and I as humans can probably tell that this is actually a five, and so we want to actually force that to be a five by typing the number five over that box. So this is an example of group verification. I'm going to go through because I want to get to field verification. Like I said, the neat part about group and field verification is that we get them both in the same screen, so we can use them in combination. So here's an example of field verification. The software tells me what field I'm looking at, and I can also see the given text here, and I can see the context of the document below. So this kind of gives me a cool little snippet so I can understand where I'm at in the document so that if this has an incorrect reading, I can override that. So if I need to override that, I can simply just type over. So it uses like any common editor of text to just simply write over and override what the software is telling us the options are. Now, if the software is correct, in this case it would be, Fremont is an actual right value, then I don't need to touch it. Only if it is wrong do I touch it? And you can see the benefit of this is that if we have personnel that want to just be able to stay on their keyboard, they don't want to have to click a mouse to go to the next, there are keyboard shortcuts. And this whole process of correcting data is actually very quick to the human that is very comfortable with doing this. So this is an example of field verification. The cool part about this is that you can use all of them in one. We have clients that use only manual verification, and then we have clients that use a hybrid of these different verification types. So when you're developing what the operators should verify and how they operate to perform their verification, just note that you have a few different options here. Not every business does it the same way, and that's perfectly okay. But just we want you to make sure that you understand the different options as far as verification goes and the different ways you can use these interfaces to speed up the verification. And the last thing I will explain is that the really cool part of this is that I can see a percentage here of how far I am through this batch and how much is verified. And I can actually see the specific location of where I am in the batch as I'm verifying this exact value. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, would you do me a favor and click the like button, the subscribe button, and even click that notification bell so that you can be notified when we post new videos. Thank you.